Welcome to a short presentation from our Diagnostics over IP series. In the next 5 minutes, we will have a look at the changes in the latest DoIP standard regarding encrypted communication. The major change of the new DoIP standard released end of 2019 is that it additionally specifies the encrypted communication over the protocol Transport Layer Security, in short TLS. Additionally, a new protocol version was introduced, which is used in the protocol header, and there's a new routing activation response code 7, which indicates to the tester that the DoIP ECU refuses unencrypted communication. Now we will have a look at the impact of these changes on a DoIP communication sequence. The initial phase, this means the physical connect, the IP address assignment, the vehicle identification, and opening the TCP connection on port 13400, is exactly the same as for a normal unencrypted DoIP session. The difference starts with the routing activation. In this case, the ECU responds with response code 7, meaning that a secure TLS socket is necessary for further communication. You can configure this behavior in the Diagnostics ISO-TP configuration dialog of CANU, selecting an adapter with an appropriate security profile and activating the Enable TLS checkbox, either for the tester or for the ECU simulation or for both. We will have a look at the details of the CANU configuration in our next video on this channel. If the ECU responded to the routing activation request with response code 7, in the next step, the tester closes the normal unencrypted TCP connection on port 13400, followed by opening up a new TCP connection on the ECU, this time using the TLS port 3496. On this new TCP connection for TLS, the TLS handshake is performed. In the TLS handshake, a secure TLS connection is negotiated. The tester and the DoIP ECU agree on the version of the TLS protocol and choose a common cipher suite. This is done in the client and server hello. Afterwards, they verify their certificates here in the key exchange, and finally complete the TLS session key exchange indicated here with these finished arrows. Now, a second routing activation sequence takes place, this time using encrypted communication over TLS. The good news is that CANU can decrypt these messages if it knows the master secret of this TLS session, and CANU can even act as a communication endpoint if the corresponding certificate is configured in the security profile of this endpoint. You can see here in this screenshot a TLS message which was decrypted by CANU and now shows that this was a DoIP routing activation request followed by a routing activation response. Finally, if the routing activation was successful, the tester and the ECU can exchange encrypted diagnostic messages. This communication is performed in the same way like for unencrypted DoIP communication. The only difference is that the diagnostic messages are encrypted over TLS and a different port is used, the TLS port 3496. For the user of the diagnostic windows, this communication is completely transparent. He can see the unencrypted result, like here the serial number in the diagnostics console. If the tester has finished the diagnostic sequence, he typically also will close the TCP channel afterwards using a standard TCP teardown sequence for the TLS connection on port 3496. Okay, thanks for watching. If this video was helpful for you, give us a like below and check out our other DoIP videos on vector.com or on our YouTube channel. In the next video, we will have a look at how to configure this DoIP over TLS communication in CANU.